everybody. October Hackathon, book review number 23 from Meenakshi Swami, teacher trainer, TLC, Chennai. So today I have selected a book. Of course it is a small book, but having a very good content in it is Life After Death. Author of the book is Swami Lokeshwaranatha. You may be thinking, Meena ma'am always giving from the spiritual perspective, but of course spirituality is very much necessary for this present conditions, and so I used to read a lot of books like that. Even that is small, so content will be great things like that. So it's very interesting. Now is there is a life after that? Of course is there, yes. There are some examples also given, and I will tell that even the particular the prestigious information or discussion he has delivered in 1985 at Narasingh Chaudhary College, Jajpur, Odisha, in India. So all that. Every year, whatever the discussions and discourses goes on that college is in the name of or dedicated to Viraja lectures, we call it as. And these lectures are named after the goddess Viraja. Why? Because the divine mother, the goddess Viraja, who is believed to be the presiding deity of Jajpur. So, this book, I will read a little bit, so it will be interesting also, I will make it interesting also, if it does not. Is there is life after death? So, the phenomena of life and death are indeed great mysteries, and especially the death part comes, it is great mysteries. Does somebody create us? Is it created by somebody? We are all created by God. Death is also maybe created by it, right? So the both are the two sides of the coin like that. If there is a birth, there will be a death. If there is a death, there will be straight away birth. That is what is happening practically. So there are two schools who are taking care of these two. Like that, what is their opinion like that? There are what are the two schools? One is the materialistic school, another one is the spiritualized school. In materialistic school, so what they are dealing with, what about life? And where did it come from? Did somebody create it? Then who created it? If you accept the theory of creation, means of life or anything else in the universe, who then created the original creator? So we used to say Brahma is the creator, right? So normally we used to say Hinduism like that. Creating something out of nothing. The very idea is absurd. Hindus maintain that there is no creation. There is instead manifestation. It is not creation, but it is manifestation. That is what materialistic school, the theory is going on like that. Whereas the spiritualites, they tell what that it is consciousness. Even the scientists, they tell consciousness or mind is also matter. But can matter be intelligent? Can matter feel or think? They will probably say, yes, it can. It can when it has a brain. Brain, it works automatically? No. So we cannot say that brain is working automatically. I am talking in front of you and sitting using my brain. I am not using. No, brain is not using. Somebody is forcing me to talk about the a life after death. Right? It is like that. So, through evolutionary process, matter has become sensitive and finally the brain has emerged. That is what in the specialist or in the spiritualists say in consciousness. Then in Hindu point of view, in Gita it is said, one who is born must die. If anybody is taking breath, then he has to die or she has to. One who die must also be reborn. That is what is said in Gita. Krishna says, all from the humble to the greater are subject to rebirth. It is absolutely nothing but about karma. And in this, even Shakespeare surely believed in the continuity of the spirit after death. How it, in his Hamlet, everybody knows about his drama Hamlet. We see the spirit of Hamlet's father appearing before Hamlet and narrating to him how he was killed by his own brother and urging that he take revenge against his uncle for this. The spirit had a subtle body but was quiet, recognizable. Like that, in the Old Testament record, a similar phenomenon when it says, and Saul perceived that it was Samuel, and he bowed with his face to the ground and did obeisance. Hindu, however, have always believed that the soul is the real man and the body is only external sheath. He discards this sheath when it gets out old and torn and picks up a new one. This beautifully explained by Krishna in the Gita. And normally in Hindus they performed the Shraddha for means it's derived from Shraddha, the respect. So we used to do Shraddham, and when Christians didn't go to the graveyard and just worship, the Muslims also go to the. So like that, they worship their forefathers or like that and all. So the soul after that, what is the soul after that? There are different lokas. Lokas means it's a world. Many worlds are there. So normally we used to say, yeah, those who are doing good karma, they will go to heaven. Those who are doing bad things, they will go to Patal. So heaven and Patal is like that. That going to Asuras, if we are going to do some bad karma. If we are doing good karma, we will go to heaven with Indra-Indra-Sri, you know. So it is said that when a person dies and he reaches to the God, that's what Krishna says. When a person comes to me and mixing with me, then there won't be anything. Otherwise, anybody dies, rebirth is there. That is what Krishna says in Gita. I will tell a story, it's very interesting. You might have heard about Nachiketa. So once his father was performed a sacrifice which required that he gave away all his belongings, all his possessions. He gave out his cows and whatever is there, just he. So Nachiketa, very intelligent enough to understand the blasphemy of this protest. And he protested and often the father cursed him by saying, go to Yama. Who is Yama? Yama is the god of death. He went to the house of Yama and he was waiting there. And Yama was not there for 3 days. After that he came, because you know that Yama is very good in hospitality. So Yama said, Yama thought himself that I could not take care of Nachiketa properly. So he wanted to give 3 boons to him. So So he told one boon against each day of his inability to receive Nachiketa with the courtesy. It is the last boon that Nachiketa asked for, which relates to death. Nachiketa asked Yama, please tell me what happens when death overtakes a man. Is he completely extinct, or does something of him is leaving behind? At first Emma was in a fix what to give the answer and how to give the answer. He was very adamant to get the answer from Emma. So what he did, but the adamancy, what is that? He would accept nothing short of an answer to this question. After death, any force or any power is behind it. Perhaps Emma was testing him, and when he was satisfied, he revealed that what is considered the highest truth, it is the truth about the nature of the cosmos, about the ultimate reality, about man's relations with the ultimate reality. And allied subjects of two. When he taught is known as Vedanta to Nachiketa, the essence of the Vedas in common parlays. There are three source books, we call it as a Vedanta, Upanishads, and the Gita and Brahma Sutra. One say that Vedanta is the culmination of philosophical thinking in India. So, a concrete case about birth after death. I will read that also, then I will conclude. A lot remains in nowadays going on about people who claim they remember about their past lives. Several foundations are supporting such research. The research is producing startling evidence in favor of reincarnation. One of those engaged in this research, Professor Ian Stevenson of the Department of Parapsychology, University of Virginia, he recorded many cases like this along with his support. So once what happened was, the Swamiji Lokeshwarananda, he just met him and he discussed about this. I have personally met Professor Stevenson and discussed this matter with him. He is not concerned about the philosophy. He is concerned only about the facts. The philosophy is entirely different. The fact is entirely different. So he says, all over the world, such cases can be met. How this possible? He doesn't know that. In volume, one of his some of the books, he has told about one Dolan Champa. It happened to know that this girl and his parents were very well. When she was barely 3 or 4 years old, she began to say that she was a man in the previous life, in her previous life, and she belonged to a well-known family called Bhardwaj. So, when she was 6, she insisted that she is taken to her original home, Bhardwaj's home. So, how, just what you will thinking about, oh, how this girl will be, what is like that, no? So, it's something curiously you must know about. So, what happened was, she said she would saw the way only she was taken to Bhardwaj. She could not identify the house, though, as it later transpired, she had led her parents very close to it. She made another attempt and she succeeded in that. And she not only took her parents into the right house, but also identified all members of the family. She even showed her clothes and articles of daily use. The girl is now 17, but even now she sometimes talks of her old home, though not as often as before, because now she is older, she is not a baby. This is only a brief outline of the whole case. Then Stevenson says there are hundreds of such cases he and his colleagues have come across. He says they have checked and rechecked and rechecked the facts of each case before accepting them as true. So, in that, what we can say? One may question the soundness of the philosophy about reincarnation, but not reincarnation itself. Life after death is life through circumstances may change. There is no escape from the cycle of birth and death. It's just like a circle or cycle of birth or cycle of death. So long as one does not know that is not the body but the spirit, which is the same in every being and everywhere, that is called Brahman, is Brahman. So when the mind does goes, so we also go, no? Nothing will be there. So who does this? The spiritual power. That is what life after death. It's an interesting thing, right? So nothing going to be harm you by reading this. And sometimes we can talk to that souls, no? So in psychology we used to have like that. So it was very interesting. So thank you very much for listening to me. I will come back to you with another book review by evening or tomorrow. Very nice of you. Have a nice day.